wonderful. It's a pleasure for me to be with you. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to do it from the beginning of the day, but I heard a little bit about the things and I listened to it. And I think, based on my experience in my work that I do in the high tech, and I'm in the kind of I'm a VP in the headquarters of the global corporation, and we have also people working in India as well as in other countries. I see a lot of commonality and potential between the Indian people and the Israeli people, and nothing new to talk about that. And the interesting part is I've seen it in the business, and I've seen it in the CII that we have related to the Tel Aviv University, and the Israeli commerce and high-tech companies and other kind of companies, the Indian companies. But also from the educational point of view, and this is the thing that I've heard, and I think it's very interesting because I'm being asked all the time in many places that I go, what is unique about Israel? And many people use the slogan of the startup nation, whatever kind of slogans that people refer to. And many countries want to kind of repeat it, try to do the same thing. And there was a debate whether it's something that goes with DNA or something that goes by education. And I'm the part of people that think it's the education. It's the kind of environment that you provide to the people. There are many, we don't have many, much time, so I'll be very short on that, and I'm sure that you know that many people use like synonym words, but they are not really synonym, like creativity and ingenuity and innovation. And it's not an entrepreneurship, and those three are not really the same. And the good thing, or the way to do the right thing, in my personal view, is if you take the ability to take the creativity and turn it into a business, into an entrepreneurship, then this is the kind of innovation that we are looking for. And I think that the combination between a great academia and potential and professors and people who are dealing with all the kind of things, with the most advanced plus, the thing that we have in Tel Aviv University, the people in Turkey, and that's the diversity. Ethical Israel was talking about the diversity between art and humanities and technology. If you take a great academia and you take the industry and work in collaboration with that, and if you have that kind of, I won't say sponsorship, but understanding of the government as well, that is a nice triangle that can work very well. From my experience, I was delivering here for many years in Europe, together with the industry. And later on, with Boston Corporation, we worked together with Tel Aviv universities and other universities, and not only in Israel, but also in the US. And we started a little bit in Bangalore recently, also with some of the institutions. This is a great combination. Now, if you add to that a diversity from a multinational point of view, which is like India and Israel, get other kind of things, I think more like postdocs, like you said, or others in Israel, and maybe Israelis in India, and things like that, that can be very, very interesting. Now, last point before I go to like the gratitude, because it's the end of the day, I think also that there is one thing which is somewhat from the experience that I have with my Indian friends, which you can do in India, may help in India. We have any problem with health entrepreneurship, with health innovation in some way. In Israel, I think, fortunately, we got into a point that if you try something and you fail, it's okay, as long as you have done the right thing, which is if somebody is looking into the world, sees something, has a great idea, thinks he's going to conquer the world, and tries to do it, no problem, you can try again, you can fall. Like an expression that we have, like a cat with nine lives. You try again, and then you succeed. Actually, if you try a few times, I personally, and some of my colleagues, we see it as an advantage, because you are experienced, you have some good in the back, so you do things better. And from what I have from my friends in India, in the Indian society, this is going to change in India, and the Indian mothers, to be more tolerant to this. then it's not that bad, then I think it can help in the area of entrepreneurship and innovation, and to combine it all together to push things forward. I would like to take the opportunity, since it's a pleasure for me to speak on behalf of the Tel Aviv University for the great day that we have here, I would like to mention especially, unfortunately we didn't have enough time to talk, but I would say that the Sakal Media Group for your part, and Ranan for the initiative from the Tel Aviv University. I looked in the internet and I found out that you have quite a few editors, and this is the first time in Israel. So, very nice, very good. It's a good place to start. And I hope it will be just the beginning, that we'll move forward and do a lot of things. And finally, I would like to have to thank the people behind the table, sometimes in the front, but not if you know if you see them. And it's the two teams of people that help on the Indian side and Thailand. I hope I'm not saying it in the wrong way, and Krishna, and on the Israeli side, Yuval,